The Puget Sound region has always posed a challenge for transportation. We used to get around in canoes, schooners, steamers, ferries. In the modern era, we began to build bridges.
And today, we're going to talk about a bridge disaster that changed the way bridges are built.
Engineers have come up with a number of ideas and solutions for getting over the waterways of the Puget Sound region. Floating bridges, for example, which sounds like kind of a contradiction in terms. In a couple of cases, those bridges have worked well, but they've also had disasters. At least two sank, the Hood Canal Bridge in 1979 and the Mercer Island Bridge in 1990, both as a result of storms, and both sank in part because hatches were left open that filled with water. The most epic bridge failure in American history, and perhaps world history, was at the Tacoma Narrows in 1940. And not only did the bridge collapse, the collapse was caught on film and thus immortalized. The Tacoma Narrows Bridge crossed the narrowest point in Puget Sound between the Olympic Peninsula and the mainland near Tacoma. The bridge had been controversial from the start. Some claimed it was just a boondoggle that would benefit Tacoma. Others said there wouldn't be enough traffic to justify it. The bridge was built very narrow, just two lanes. Solid steel girders, instead of the usual open trusses, were meant to secure the bridge against the wind. Shortly after the bridge's opening in 1940, drivers noticed that the bridge deck began to undulate, kind of like a roller coaster, and they could see it in the wind moving like this. So much so that often the car ahead of them disappeared. That roller coaster effect was what gave the name to the bridge, Galloping Gertie. 4 months after the bridge opened, on November 7th, 1940, people noticed that the bridge was doing something peculiar. There were 42-mile-an-hour winds funneling through the narrows. The bridge began to undulate in that roller coaster motion, but even worse, people noticed that it began to move in opposite directions like a corkscrew. One man who was on the bridge said that the bridge deck was twisting so much at a 45-degree angle that when it went to the side, he could actually see the water below. A newspaper editor from the Tacoma News Tribune, Leonard Coatsworth, abandoned his car on the bridge and crawled back to safety. In the car, he left his daughter's little dog, Tubby, and when the bridge collapsed, the car and Tubby went down. Tubby was the only fatality. Collapse of Galloping Gertie was recorded in spectacular footage. Most people are familiar with the image of the bucking bridge from the Tacoma side, but recently some lost film has been found photographing the bridge collapse from the Gig Harbor side. Here we have some of the debris of Galloping Gertie. This appears to be a piece of concrete, probably from the roadbed. Here's a piece of steel with a rivet hole in it. Down here, we also have a piece of what appears to be the roadbed, and interestingly, it actually has the original bridge paint still on it. This was found on a beach near the Narrows. After the bridge collapsed, there was a lot of finger pointing. Engineers pointed the finger at each other. Designers pointed their fingers at the government. Consultants pointed their finger at the bridge designers. No one had thought, and it was not standard practice at the time, to put a suspension bridge through wind tunnel testing. No one had thought to take the aerodynamics into account. A bigger, heavier, stronger bridge was built in 1950 to replace Galloping Gertie. It was called Sturdy Gertie. In 1951, 75-mile-an-hour winds came through the Narrows, and Sturdy Gertie did fine. Wind tunnel testing of steel structures became a pretty standard practice after Galloping Gertie. For example, we have a structure in Seattle that was wind tunnel tested at the University of Washington by some of the same engineers. It's called the Space Needle. This is a piece of the wreckage of Galloping Gertie, according to the State Department of Transportation. The rest of the wreckage is down at the bottom of the Tacoma Narrows, where it's a National Historic Site.